up, guys? It's Joel Hendershot again here with OP Noobs, PC Gaming by PC Gamers. We're here at PAX South here in San Antonio, and we're here looking at the Aftercharge booth here with Lawrence, the Chief Communications Officer.
Hey,
how are you doing?
Doing really good.
How you guys have an amazing setup here. You got a couple teams going, yeah. I'm assuming all day.
It's an esports setting, okay? So we have two teams on each of the sides, and we've got a spectator in the middle. It's perfect for us.
All right, well, tell us a little bit about Aftercharge.
All right, so Aftercharge is a 3v3 asymmetrical FPS in which one team is invisible and the other team is invincible.
Okay.
So how can that work? Is that the invisible team, of course, their goal is not to kill their enemy team. It's impossible.
Yeah.
It's to destroy what we call extractors. There are six extractors on the map. They have to bash them to pieces. That's how they win. And on the other side, the defenders, they have to stop that from happening. They have to find and shoot down all three robots. That's how they win.
All right, excellent. What kind of options do you have as far as characters, play styles, and things like that?
But right now, what we have and what we're showing here at PAX South is three different characters on the two sides. So there's three different enforcers and three different robots. They each have unique abilities and unique play styles. For example, if we have an enforcer that's more a support, he can build up walls, he can create recharge stations to kind of control the battlefield. Like when there's another enforcer that's more about chasing down robots. So they all have different play styles and different abilities.
Awesome. And what's coming up in the future, in the near future?
Yeah, in the very near future, we'll have a test event with our Discord community in 2 weeks. On January 26th, and we'll be bringing two new characters fresh out of the oven that we still haven't tested at the studio.
Cool.
But we'll have the community try them out, tell us what they think. So it's our next event. We run one every month. So if you want to try Aftercharge before it's launched, I encourage you to join our Discord.
Okay, awesome. So, yeah, so they join your Discord. Where else can they find you guys as far as community and stuff like that?
They can find us on Twitter and Facebook at Aftercharge. And you can also sign up on our newsletter on aftercharge.com. We usually inform people of when the test sessions are. We force them to join Discord. And we also update on the new content we're creating.
Awesome. And when will this amazing game get into the hands of gamers?
It's going to be 2018. We have no official date or official month of launch.
Right.
But it's going to be this year.
And you guys are a relatively small studio, right, compared to some of the other kind of esports games going, right?
Yeah, it doesn't look like it when you look at our booth, but we're only eight people team.
Wow.
Actually, six people making the game, because I'm not making the game.
Right.
I'm just a marketing guy. I know we're a smaller team than what people expect when they see our game, and that's cool for us to hear.
And what is the most exciting thing about Aftercharge compared to everything else that's on the market?
I think what's fun with Aftercharge is the strategy involved in the two teams. They play very differently, and they're really team-focused. When you're playing robots, it's really about strategizing as a team. You cannot win as a star player, especially. If you play alone, you're going to lose. And playing Enforcer is the same thing. You are only three to cover a kind of a big arena. So if you play alone, and you don't talk to your team, it's not gonna work. So team focus is what's most unique with our game, I think.
Cool, and how many maps can people play on?
At the moment, and in the next events as well, we only have one map right now, but of course we plan on having more. When we launch, we're still aiming for three maps, we'll see. But we're gonna treat this game as a game as a service, so when it's launched, we'll add more characters, more maps. As long as it's viable, we'll add content.
Right, and I'm assuming you're going to get some contents going, some community events, tournaments, and things like that?
Yeah, definitely. We'll run events and tournaments. We really have a kind of a competitive esports focus on our game. We love competitions. We already ran a tournament in Montreal to test things out, so we'll definitely be running tournaments, that's for sure.
Awesome. Is there anything else that you'd like to give a shout-out or let people know about the game, about what's coming up?
I would say that again. You should join our Discord community.
Cool.
This is where everything happens. We share everything we're working on at the studio, even if it's not finished, even if it's not going to end up in the game. We share everything we do.
Perfect. Well, you have a great game here. It was a pleasure talking to you.
Yeah, man. Me too.
Thank you.